But every week, the newspapers are full of articles about young people and unemployment. So I thought I'd take a look at this week's crop. The Times tells us that this week it's the conference of the Confederation of British Industry, and resolutions are flying around to launch new incentives for the unemployed, especially young people. The Times also tells us that every unemployed person costs the country £4,500. The Daily Express ran an article telling us that the government are going to put an extra £134 million into keeping youngsters off the dole. And how are they going to do this at long last? They're going to create more places for sixth formers. Well, it might not give you a job, but it certainly keep you out of the very embarrassing statistics. The Daily Mirror have run an article as well called "Dole Kids Prefer Babies to Boredom." They tell us that young ladies prefer to get pregnant than to get a job. The other sensational solution of the week comes from Tony Marlow, MP for Nottingham, who is launching a scheme called Youth Community Service. This appeals to youngsters to give up a year of their lives in order to serve the community, doing activities ranging from art appreciation right through to the military. What do we young people really want all this organised assistance? That's the subject of this week's discussion. When I say to you the words community service, what is the first thing that that conjures up in your mind? Yeah?
Well, the first thing that conjures up in my mind is something like, if you go to court, like as a punishment, you have so many hours to do off in the community.
Yeah, but don't you think, though, that it should be more than the punishment, that young people should have a... Do you feel that young people have a responsibility towards society that they should do anyway?
To a certain degree. Maybe the long-term unemployed who don't have any real hope or any real chance of getting a job, shall we say, those people without any qualifications to speak of.
I mean, that almost sounds like you want to hive off all the failures, all the people who haven't got exams, all the people who've failed all their interviews, and put them in a big clot like, you know, stale milk together. Do you think, like, suggestions like this, which various people are putting forward, is totally connected with unemployment, or that it's something that would benefit all young people anyway? Rather like you get lots of people saying that, you know, national service made a man of me. You know, what do you feel about that?
Well, I don't know. I don't want to. I wouldn't like to have to do it because I know what I want to do.
Yes.
And I think it would sort of be a bit of a nuisance, and it would take a whole chunk out of when I could be getting on with what I want to do.
But don't you think that if you did something different from what you were going to do, it would make a different person of you, it would give you a better perspective on what you went on to do after that?
I don't think it's any harm in making people doing what they don't like. I mean, taking a year or 6 months out of a 16 to 25 year old's life isn't that much, and we'd all like to spend our time doing what we like doing. We'd have a perfect world in that situation. Nobody would be unhappy. So really, to take a year, even if you're doing something you don't like doing, so long as it's helping, it's being a benefit, I don't think that's a bad thing, really.
Well, you know, communities are built, don't they? They just kind of sit indoors, go to youth club, and I think they should be, say, take a month and go to the hospital, see the old grannies, and probably go and youth club and things like that for a month and see if they like it, and if they like it, they could do some more.
Yeah, so how would you organise? Well, this is for all young people should be made to
do this. Say, after about 17, and you're just dossing around, they should see the community and see what's going on, see who's got the problems and who hasn't.
Perhaps now we will come over to, I guess this afternoon, Michael Meacher, MP for Oldham...
West.
That's the one. Perhaps now you're involved with Youth Call, the committee that's trying to put through Parliament a bill to make a very large youth service scheme in this country. Perhaps you could say a bit about the difference between that scheme and other schemes that are already existing, and why you want to make it such a broad thing for young people.
Well, the existing scheme is confined to the unemployed. And what we believe is that nothing to do with youth unemployment, but as a thing in its own right, as a benefit to people, as part of their education, part of the training for life, it would benefit people in, say, the 16 to 25 year age range, and I know it would have benefited me, if there were the opportunity of doing 6 to 12 months community service, there would be a real contribution made to society, which would, I think, expand the horizons of many people, and which would be open to, if it were not actually to be compulsory, which I oppose, to people from whatever class or background they've come to, whether or not they've got a job to go to.
Right. How do you react to that? Will you buy that or not?
I wondered, what sort of wage would these people be taking home? I mean, would they be taking sort of basic dole money, or because they can't obviously live without some sort of wage for 6 to 12 months? It's a long time.
Oh, absolutely. I certainly think it should be at least as much as unemployment benefit. I'd say somewhat above.
Well, picking up on that, I mean, the first thing you picked up on that was about money. Yeah. Do you think people would go for it more for money than for the experience?
I think that if they wanted to do the job where they had an idea of helping people, that they would, if the money was better, it would make them more inclined to do that, because obviously they've got to live somewhere, they've got to pay the rent, they've got to pay their mother for some sort of food or something.
Okay, then perhaps we could say something about what type of things you'd find appealing. What type of help would you want to give to the community as a young person? Anybody? Yeah.
Well, I think a lot of the types of community services, lots of people are unaware of what they are. They just have a sort of stereotype image of people just digging granny's gardens and things like that, and they don't know there's lots and lots of different types of community service, and people take an interest in things that interest them.
We were talking before this programme about people could choose, if it was compulsory or widely encouraged, as you nicely put it, they could choose between the armed forces, the social services, some type of land army, or going into sort of, you know, education, doing something in the arts even, you know, and theatre and things like that.
Yeah.
Would these be viable possibilities, and who would be organising that?
I suppose there isn't an unlimited number of choices, and if everyone went for the same one, you'd have to say that we've only got so many places available. It's rather like the theatre. You know, this particular theatre's full, but there are three others which you might like to go to.
Yes, except that's for one evening, and this will be for a year of somebody's life.
Yes, but the other choices would be pretty wide.
Yeah.
So even if you didn't get your first choice, you should certainly expect to get your second.
Yeah. What sort of things would you go for? Say you were given, you know, five of those choices which we've just listed, army, working on the land, social services, perhaps working in education or something. What things would you go
culture.
For on that? What of those would appeal to you most?
The army.
The army?
Yeah.
Why the
make
army?
Make a man of you.
He's going to make a man of you. Are you serious about that?
No, I'm serious, because all the others, all the other community services, you know, digging canals and that,
well, not just that.
All right. Well, all the other services. You're really, like you say, you're doing a service for the community. You're not really doing anything for yourself.
But I think it would help the people who didn't know what they wanted to do. Say they went into work in a hospital, they might suddenly decide, oh, this is what I want to do with my life. And it might help people who haven't got any direction of what they want to do to find out what they want to do.
Work experience, yeah.
I think it's very true that people may find themselves, find an identity in doing things that they'd never thought of before.
Sounds like there's a whole lot of grannies going hungry where all you people come from. Do you find that insulting as young people, that whenever young people have to do anything, it's always like, you know, notice the guy on the film said clearing out drains or sewers or whatever he said. Do you find that insulting, that the first thing people think of is that young people make them clean out the sewers? How do you react towards that? Yeah.
Why have 16 to 25-year-olds, you still get 26-year-old people out of work, 27? Mm. I mean, something to be, where do we cut the line? 25? I mean, you still get unemployed people.
Yeah,
but it isn't to do with the unemployed. I mean, you can see it as an answer to youth unemployment. I think it's nothing of the sort. I think it is part, as I say, of the educational system. I mean, part of that is in school, but we ought perhaps to have a wider view of what you need, the kind of experiences you need to train for life. And one of these is being out, working in industry, working in the fields, working in the social services. And that wouldn't in any way be an answer to unemployment.
I can see you tutting. Do you want to say something?
Why should we all have to do it?
But
they haven't done it.
Well, I wish we had. I mean, I wish I had had to do that.
Would you? I mean, if you were our age, would you have wished to have done that?
I wouldn't wish to clean out the sewers. I mean, I quite agree that I think that is an insulting job, and frankly, I wouldn't choose to do that. And I don't think people should be made to do any of these things. I think it's extremely important that they should have choice.
Yes.
I think one of the problems today is that young and old people don't relate with each other. And I think that compulsory voluntary work would force young people to come into contact with older people.
Anybody want to follow up on that? Do you want to?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, okay, down here.
I think that the compulsory element might make them resent the older people more.
You think so?
Having to relate to them, yes.
Yeah, and you're back to the sort of, I'm the boss and you're the worker.
Yeah.
Because
yeah,
you've got to do it, and I think that's wrong.
So do you feel that this would make an even bigger age gap?
I think it would, yes. Mm-hmm.
If it's something that you've got to, if you think to yourself, oh, God, I've got to go and help Granny do so-and-so, you're not going to get on any better with her because it's something you've got to do. Whereas if you're,
Granny
if you're, yeah, if you're volunteering to do it, you think, great, I might see Granny today, go and help her, etc.
I feel sorry for Granny already.
Well, just a few. You're going to get such an imbalance if it is voluntary. The people that would normally do those sort of things anyway, and the people who'd rather sit back and not do anything.
Yeah.
And I think that's very unfair.
Right, one last one.
Isn't it true that if people who were unemployed, they would see community service as a last resort if they couldn't get a job when it was when they were getting paid for community service, and you'd get an imbalance in the people who weren't qualified and who were near the bottom of the heap.
So why can't everybody do something for the community if they want to? Well, it shouldn't be this 16 to 25.
Why is it 25?
Well, I think that's a very good argument. I very much support that. I mean, I think that, say, once in your 40s and once in your 50s, you also ought to take 6 months or 12 months off to do service. I don't think this should be just for young people.
Yes, but the thing is young people can be pushed around. Young people can be made what to do. Somebody of 50 or something, the government would not dare make a legislation against a person like that.
Just because we're young and being pushed around, that's just completely wrong.
Is it going to be done locally? Because if you get a local authority who's stingy, like where we come from, Barnet, they'll just have cheap labour and they won't have proper professionals to do the jobs. And
yeah.
Well, under the scheme, as we envisage it, the total number of people employed in Barnet Social Service Department, whatever it is, would be fixed at a certain level now, and they would only get assistance if they maintain that number of full-time jobs. They wouldn't get it otherwise.
I had a friend that did it once. They made her dig a hole one afternoon and fill it up the next morning. I mean, that's just not letting youth have a mind of their own
at
all.
That's the typical attitude about the British Army on the Rhine. It's the kind of make work which goes on. Now, obviously, that would be appalling. I mean, we have to be sensitive and imaginative about this, and we have to provide, you know, for real things to be done. But heaven's sake, I mean, there are so many things when you look around in our society which need doing. It would be appalling if we invented things of the kind you're suggesting.
It would have to be very regulated. I mean, it just could easily be done, surely.
I tell you what, let's finish this debate by taking a vote on that. How many people agree with you up there that that the compulsory, if it was compulsory, would be the best way to level everything out? So, well, let's have a show of who's for that. That's quite a few. That's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. He's scratching his head. 9 and a head scratch. Let's. Who's against that? So that's more people against than for. Well, thank you very much. No doubt we'll be hearing your views on that subject.